Welcome back to Cold Can Do.
In this episode, I'll demonstrate how to create simple sequential numbering using data merge. This example uses the following invoice where the number range will be 9001 through to 11,000, but it will have leading zeros so that the number is always 7 characters long. I'll demonstrate two methods that will create the leading zeros, as well as two other methods that require a workaround, but achieve the same result. Let's begin with the first method, a free script called Indy's Number Generator. A link to the script is provided in the description below. From here, we want to choose from the options the all integers. Type our first record, which will be 9001, and our end record, which will be 11,000. We don't need to shuffle them, but we do want a minimum length. As we said, we want 7 characters. So we'll have 7, and we'll make sure our filling character is a 0, which it is. It doesn't need to be broken into groups like a credit card number. It also doesn't need any text before or after it. And we want the member separator to be paragraph, although there are a few options you can choose here. We don't want to put this into a new text frame. Instead, we want to save this as a CSV file. So let's go create, and we're going to call it numbers. And then just go OK. From here, we then go to our data merge palette, go select data source, and go to our numbers, and go open. So from here, we now have our leading zeros. It goes to the end of the records correctly. And the zeros also break correctly over that crucial marker between 9,999 and 10,000. So that's the first method. I'll now demonstrate the second method, which is using Microsoft Excel. We're just going to start off with the header row, and we're going to just use no. It's easy enough. We then have to type our first number. In this instance, it's going to be 0009001. But notice what happens. The 0000 at the start, the leading zeros disappear. We'll discuss this later. In the meantime, to make the numbers carry on all the way to 11,000, there's a few ways you can do this. The first way is to hold the Option key and look for the bottom right-hand corner of the cell. You'll see there's an additional plus. And you can drag that down. But that will take a very long time. So that's not my preferred method. There's an additional method, which is where you type equals the cell above plus 1. And again, you can do the same trick we just previously did. Again, that will take you quite some time. We can go copy, then Control G, go to, and we want to go to cell A2001. So with this number range, this will effectively take us to 11,000. Now what we're going to do is hold Command Shift Home, and holding the Shift key, we're just going to go down on that arrow key twice and then go paste. So that will paste all the records through. That's a good way, but it's not the way that I would really use. So the way that I would really do this would be to highlight the cell in question and then go to Fill, Series. From here, we want to select columns. The type is linear, the step value is 1, and we want to stop at 11,000, which is the last record that we need. And you'll see that goes all the way through to 11,000. Now to format the cells so that they have leading zeros. So highlight the column by clicking the A so that there's a little black arrow pointing downwards. Then go Format Cells. To do this, we had to select Custom. From the type, we want to replace a word General with 7 zeros in this instance. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Go OK. And you'll see all of a sudden we have leading zeros. And more specifically, we'll go to Record A1001. So this is the mark at which the 9,999 becomes 10,000, but you can see the zeros close up as opposed to an additional zero appearing at the start of the 10,000. So our number range is now right. From here, we file save, and you should just be able to use this here, comma separated values, but there are a whole other range of formats you can choose, such as these. Any of these will do, but we will use comma separated values, and we're just going to call that numbers. So those were my two preferred methods of preparing sequential numbers. There are two more, but they don't necessarily put the leading zeros in, and I'll demonstrate them now. The first one is a script by Loic Agen called Lottery Number. This is much simpler than the Indys numbering script. Works generally the same way. So our first record was 9,001. Our final record was 11,000. Now it does have a feature here to add zeros, so we'll go and do that. One thing I do like about this script is it puts the data already into the data merge, unlike the last two methods. But what it doesn't do is add the leading zeros that we wanted. The good news is that when we get to that magic mark of 1,000, it has added a leading zero there, but it hasn't put the two leading zeros at the start. So in this instance, we just add them manually. So that's the method using Loic Agen's lottery number script, and the link will be in the description below. So lastly, this method of making the sequential numbers uses a website, namely textmechanic.com. I'll put the link in the description below. Again, our start number is 9,001. Our end number is 11,000. Now it has a little feature here called pad. Now that's similar to the leading zeros. So we'll add that. And then we'll just generate a list of numbers. And you can see, much like Loic script, it's added one leading zero, but it has not added the two that we need. So to remedy this, where it has prefix numbers, we just type in two zeros, generate the list of numbers, and then we can save that. But before we do, we just have to drop our cursor into the top here and type in NO. This will give us our header record. From here, I'm going to call that numbers, and I'm just going to go save as. So from here, I can go open, and that launches text edit. So if we scroll down, again, we get to that magic number between 9,999 and 10,000. And you can see the amount of leading zeros is correct. So we can now import that using the select data source feature in Adobe InDesign. So lastly, I just want to discuss why I like using data merge as opposed to using a trick where you would say, make the very first page number 9,001 and then continue it for a 2,000 page document, or using a trick such as bullets and numbering where the numbering starts at 9,001 and then you just carry it on 2,000 times. Well, the reason is if I want the numbering to appear more than once on the page, I can do that. Similarly, if I was to have a two-page document, I can have that as well. It's something I can't necessarily do with the other tricks, I'll call them tricks because that's what they are. This is a much more reliable method, and it also doesn't make a very large file, especially if I'm using export to PDF, which I recommend that you do. That's great if you're doing one invoice per page, but if you're doing something that is several items per printed sheet, such as lottery tickets, then you'll need a different method, and that will be described in a future video. That's it for the video. You can get in touch with me via Twitter at ColeCanDo, check out the blog ColeCanDo.com, and see my articles at InDesignSecrets.com, as well as all of the usual terrific content. Till we meet again, I'll see you later.